our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Amen.
A leper came to Jesus. He knelt in front of him and pleaded, "If you are willing, you can make me clean." And Jesus healed him. But before I go into explaining or examining the meaning of this miracle, I want to tell you what leprosy is. Because every time I come across a text like this, and it says, a leper came to Jesus, I can just see some people's minds, you guys have been here often enough, I hope you know, they see this four-legged spotted animal. What's a leper coming to Jesus? Huh? No, this is a human being who has leprosy, which is a skin disease, eh? And so as basic as that may be, we have to know that. But the thing about leprosy, and I've just been learning some of this stuff in my later years, leprosy was a dreaded disease because real leprosy affected the nerve endings. And so that area, the infected area, would lose all sensation. You couldn't feel. And so the danger was that you could burn yourself or scald yourself because you don't have any feeling. And so it was a dangerous disease. And as the disease developed, the injury to the nerves caused discolored patches and blisters in the affected area. And that would be what people didn't like. They could see it. And they were afraid of it. And so a leper, if he was out in public, had to literally go around saying, "Unclean, unclean," so that if I'm coming towards you, you would hear me. And you'd go right around me. You wouldn't come near me. And so they were shunned by the whole world, exiled to a life without family, without friends. The leper would live in utter hopelessness. And that was the situation of this particular leper, this man who came to Jesus. But at least he still had some hope. He came to Jesus with his pathetic cry, "If you will, you can make me clean." Now this man knew that Jesus was able to heal him. He had seen him heal others. In fact, Jesus' reputation by now was taking off, it was soaring, and people were discovering, you know, this guy can calm storms, he can cast out demons, why, he can even heal people who are blind. Sure, he can help you, can't he?
Yeah.
And so this man knew that Jesus was able. And I emphasize that, first of all, because there are a lot of people today who wonder if Christ is able. Many modern men and women have a small God, and they don't think he is able to help them. And our science and technology hasn't helped the matter. Science and technology has robbed many people of their sense of wonder about the power and wonder of God. It's not that these people don't believe in God, it feels they just feel like, well, what can he do? I don't need him. If I'm sick, I'll go to a doctor, and I'll get taken care of. Or if I need daily bread, I'll go to festival food. I'll buy my bread. I don't need God, unless something comes along that's unmanageable, like an incurable disease. Otherwise, they don't really see much use for God. They don't have time. What can he do? German philosopher Friedrich Nietzsche wrote a concept which is he called the last man. It's the philosophy that cuts a little close to home for people who live in an affluent society such as we do. According to Nietzsche, the last man is the person who is lulled to it by so much comfort and affluence he becomes apathetic to everything around him. He has no passion or compassion. He rejects religion, transcendent ideals, or any causes larger than his own needs. In fact, the last man's life consists of nothing more than taking it easy and watching the world. been describing a lot of people today.
Oh, yeah.
Have you lost that fervor you once had for God? How's your faith?
Fine.
Do you have a sense of God's presence in your daily life? God is here. God is with us every day. And God is able, as Paul says, to do immeasurably more than we ask or imagine. But we don't really believe, do we? You see, the problem isn't with God. Something in our world has robbed people of a sense of both God's presence and God's power. A man with leprosy came to Jesus because he knew that Jesus was able to cure him. Did you say that? Have you gone to God? Can you say that He is able to help you in any problem you have? Could you honestly say that? The man with leprosy knew that Jesus was able, but his question was he willing? Mark says he knelt in front of the Master and pleaded, "If you are willing, you can make me clean." If you are willing, just think about that. It makes perfect sense. Sure, Christ is able, but does he really care about me? I mean, think about it.